It's your girl Syria checking in with, you guessed it, another video. If you've been keeping up with my YouTube channel, you may have noticed that I've been doing daily vlogs. I cannot forget to also provide you guys with more videos on tech and style and tutorials and all that good stuff. You guys gave me 1,000 views on my What's in My iPhone video. And I did tell you that if you gave me 1,000 views, I would give you an editing tutorial. So you kept your promise and I'll keep mine. I look a little different because I got some new hair going on. Drop a comment if you like it. If you don't like it, too bad. Today I'm going to use iMovie to edit a recent project, back to school lookbook. So the first thing you're gonna need to do is open up your iMovie app, either on your iPhone or on your iMac or on your MacBook or on your iPad. It's a program and app that's available on Apple devices. The first video editing program that I learned was a program called Avid, and I learned that in college and school. And I graduated with a major in video arts and technology. So I know what I'm doing, guys. Most recently, I found that it was more efficient and quick for me to edit on iMovie because I could edit on the go. I could edit on my iPhone. I could transfer those edits over to my desktop or to my laptop, you know, wherever I am, because I might be at this spot, then I'm going to that spot, then I'm going to that spot, but I still want to finish my editing project. I want to finish my video. So that's the thing that I like about Apple, is that I can go to different devices and pick up where I left off. So right now, I'm going to begin. As you can see here, I have opened up the iMovie program. It'll say My Movie. I'm gonna name this Back to School Lookbook. Okay, I'm going to select Import Media, and I'm just going to get the files from my drive that I'm going to use to create the video. So I remember that while I was doing the photography portion of the shoot, as soon as I was done with each look, I would have somebody take the camera and just kind of like pan up and down to see my whole outfit. So I kind of had an idea already of how I wanted this to come out. So I already have one of the looks, and I'm going to import the other look. The files from the second look are uploaded already. As you can see, this area right here where it says Project Media, it shows all of the files that I just dropped down that I'm going to use for this video. I'm going to drag over the first look. So you see here this file where I am wearing an orange top and some clear glasses and white pants. Shout out to Fudoma for the styling. Shout out to DHI Incorporated, Deborah Hughes, for providing the pants. Sanjung Won, Korean clothing line. Really, really dope stuff. What I'm gonna do here is just select over. You see that yellow border, and just drag over. And like, it allows you to drag over the amount that you'd like. And then once you let go, this little button appears at the bottom right, and it's a cross sign, and you can select that and it'll just add that segment of the video down over here. And then if you want to remove that, just click it and select delete, and it's gone. it's still going to be up here in your project media box. And you can also double click it to select the whole clip, and boom, the whole video is there at the bottom. Now you can add all the files at once by selecting each of them and just dropping them in, or you could just do look by look. So let me do look by look just because I want to focus on that one look, and I'm just going to first look over it. This line right here allows you to adjust the volume. You take your mouse and just go over this line that's in that, like, that blue area. You just click it and drag down or drag up to adjust the volume. So I'm gonna turn the volume off by dragging the volume line down to 0% because I don't want to hear the audio. I just want to focus on the visual of it. So I'm just gonna play it and see how I like it. I think I like the first clip as opposed to the second clip. I mean, it was done kind of like, you know, not by a professional videographer or anything like that, but if I were to, you know, do it again and have like somebody who specializes in the videography to do it, or if I were to, you know, have the time to like teach the person holding the camera how to do it, I would want them to be in the same distance apart from myself, the subject, so that when I, the same distance apart for every look, in terms of where they're standing apart from the subject, so that everything kind of looks consistent. Let's just choose the first one. I'm going to remove the second clip. I'm just going to keep it and see how it looks beside the next file that I'm going to add. So I'm going to find that exact moment where the panning switches from down to up, right? So right around this area where it gets to the foot, right? I'm going to select there. Slowly move over to the next frame, just select the next arrow. So it looks really slow, right? Keep selecting until you see it start to pan up, right? So right around here is where you don't see any movement. Right there, you start to see some movement. So let's move back, and right there it's still. And you can just select Command B, and that will cut your frame. Now select what comes after that and just delete. So we're going to do the same for the second look. So now I'm going to find the second look where I'm wearing a different outfit. Something I would have changed and something that a professional videographer would have noticed is right in the background is that outlet where something is connected. What? You always want to make sure that you're aware of the background. I'm going to select until it stops, and you see there it's about to pan back up. So I'm just going to rewind right around there. You click that add button, put the volume to 0%, and then I'm going to play down. It's a little bit shaky, so I might just erase it, the half, and keep that part where he was panning up, right? And then I just go over here and select reverse, and that reverse will make it seem like it's going in the opposite direction. Instead of going up, it's going down. So I'm going to select it and see how it looks. Not bad. It appears that there is no pan down for that look. So I'm going to, I'll think about what I'm going to do. And I'm just going to move to the fourth look. And that's me in the holding the basketball with the turtleneck. As you can see over here, I'm looking at the camera and then I'm not. So that's a little weird. So I'm gonna start where I'm not looking at the camera and just like drag it over to worries panning completely down. Actually, right where my feet start so that you can see, you know, my whole wardrobe. I'm gonna drag over. And then right before it blacks out, I'm just gonna add it. Make sure the volume is on 0%. If one of the clips is gonna have 0% volume, then the rest of them are gonna have 0% volume. If they're all going to be about a 5 foot distance apart, then all of them have to be consistent. And that's what makes it look good. All right, so let me just play them. Yeah, this is panning up. Let me see if I want to reverse it. Yeah, that works.